everybody. Welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. We have a really special video for you today. When we go to Disneyland, we love riding the Disneyland Railroad. It's one of our favorite things to do. It's something that Bill and I both remember doing as a child. The Disneyland Railroad is amazing because it goes all the way around Disneyland. You really get to take in all of the lands, all of the sights. It's fun and relaxing, so let's go. We're starting our trip at Main Street. This is the Main Street station. We're looking at the gates to enter Disneyland. And now we're looking at Mr. Lincoln, Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln and his theater. This is an entrance. And one of the things that's really great about the Main Street station is the shaded seating for the people waiting to get on. These are the train conductors. They are just waiting to get the okay to send our train on our way. Our first stop after the Main Street station is going to be New Orleans Square. There is a beautiful view headed down Main Street as we start our journey around the bend to New Orleans Square. But as we head that way, we're going to be passing by some beautiful brush. The thing that's so amazing about this is on the other side is the ride Jungle Cruise. And when you are on Jungle Cruise, it's like you are completely in the jungle and not even in Disneyland anymore. If you noticed, we passed some beautiful items heading into New Orleans Square. And we are about to stop at the station. Right in front of us there is where you can buy a delicious, refreshing mint julep. And this is one of the stations that actually is the busiest. Usually when we are wanting to get on the train, this is one of the last places that we'll get on at New Orleans Square, because usually here the line is the longest. We are now going to be heading to Toontown Depot. As we are leaving New Orleans Square, you're going to see the kiosk where you can get a fast pass right there for Haunted Mansion. Going through this tunnel, you're going to see Splash Mountain. And after this ride, we're going to be headed into Critter County. All of the people that are walking under the bridge are headed into Critter County, and there you can ride Winnie the Pooh and friends. There's the Hungry Bear restaurant. They have a delicious hamburger there, and one of the wonderful things about this restaurant is there's some great outdoor seating with a view of the rivers of America, which we're going to be going by here in just a moment. Right below us is an entrance and exit to Star Wars Land. And as we head around this bend, you're going to see some amazing creatures off into the distance and some of them up close as well. These are the rivers of America right here in front of you. We're going to be passing the Indian chief who is welcoming us to their village. Also, across the river is Tom Sawyer's Island. It's a really great place to go out and walk around, as if you don't get enough exercise at Disneyland, but it is a great place for the kids to play. Off into the left-hand corner of the screen coming in now, you're going to see the Indian Shaman. The thing that's amazing about the Indian Shaman is he was formerly the Abe Lincoln in Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln. When they replaced him, these are the animatronics that they now have made into the Indian Shaman. You can watch him as he sits and stands. His motions are the same. There goes the Mark Twain around the corner. If you haven't ridden that ride, that is a wonderful and relaxing ride as well. And you get to see all of the Indian village down below that you're not able to see from this angle. We now have Big Thunder Mountain right there in the shot. That is one of our favorite rides. Bill and I love to ride Big Thunder Mountain, and it is always fun to ride with people who are riding it for the first time. You're going to be able to see some cute little foxes, and if you look closely, one is there inside the log. Now we're headed into a tunnel. We're heading to Toontown Depot. This is another very, very busy station, especially when Mickey and the Magical Map lets out. As we head out of this tunnel, you're going to be able to see the area for Mickey and the Magical Map, all of the seating, and the stage where the people perform off to the right-hand side. Additionally, you're going to be able to see down into Fantasyland and where people are heading in to get to the station here. Mickey's Toontown is where, if you wanted to go there and visit, you would get off the train here. It's also the entrance into Fantasyland. This bridge, if you head under the bridge below us, is into Toontown, and straight ahead is into Fantasyland. Off to the left here, you're going to see an amazing ride. A lot of people actually come here just to ride this ride. It's a Small World. Off in the distance, you can see the Matterhorn bobsleds, and right there in front of us are a million strollers. That is like primary stroller parking for this area. As we head around to It's a Small World, we're going to just get past this entrance. One of the things though that's really, really cool is all of the animals that are bushes cut into the animals for you to see. As we pass this building though, you are going to start seeing people waving. This is actually one of the most amounts of wavers I've ever seen. We are waving, waving, waving. It just kind of becomes addictive. More people wave as we go by. This here is the parade route and entrance. When the parade enters and exits by It's a Small World, it goes through right there. And we are now headed by Autopia. Autopia is a really fun ride where you can actually drive a car without a license. It is a lot of fun, and you also can see the monorail tracks. Unfortunately, a monorail isn't going by right now. That would have been really cool to be able to see that. But it is fun to see the Autopia track. There are a lot of people in line in the sun over there, and this is now Tomorrowland Station. This actually is quite a long line for this station. It's usually a bit shorter. We're now going to be heading into the tunnel. We're going to be rounding back to Main Street, but before we get to Main Street, we have some amazing things for you to see. We're going to be going into the tunnel first, and we're going to be seeing the Grand Canyon as it is today. This is a really beautiful area to see. Well, there's Bill's red shoes, first of all, but this is a really beautiful area to see a lot of wildlife and some beautiful, beautiful trees. Here we start. Look at the beautiful views. It's amazing. We've got birds flying off in the distance, but check out all of the really, really cool animals. But oh my gosh, it appears that today there's some sort of storm. It looks like there's gonna be some thunder and some lightning. Don't be startled, because it looks like there's gonna be a lightning bolt right here. Whoa, what a sight. That was really, really amazing. I'm so glad we got to experience that today with you. That is a really lovely view of the Grand Canyon. We are headed into a very different area. I hope you guys aren't afraid of dinosaurs, because we are going to see some up close and personal. That snail right there is actually Bill's favorite, but this is amazing. The colors are incredible. The lifelike dinosaurs are just amazing as well. But I will tell you that my favorite part are the pterodactyls. However, don't be startled, because here we go, boom! We've got a pterodactyl up close and personal. We've got some little babies being born, and some scrappy dinosaurs right there drinking some water. I don't think you want to mess around with them, because they look fast and dangerous. However, we now have a Tyrannosaurus Rex and a Stegosaurus. They are in the middle of a brawl. It's unknown what it's over, but I'm not getting in the middle of that. We're now headed right now back to Main Street Station. We have just about completed our entire lap around the park, and we're so glad that you guys joined us. We love the Disneyland train, and we love riding it all the way around the park. We are now back, and hopefully enough people will get off the train that everyone sitting there and waiting in line can get on, because they're hot and they're ready for their adventure to begin. Walt Disney actually was really excited to open the train. It opened July 17th, 1955, and this was one of his favorite things here at Disneyland. Everybody, we're going to end our video here. I hope you enjoyed our trip around Disneyland. We sure enjoy riding it almost every time we come. Sometimes we use it just to travel from one land to the next, but sometimes we like to get on the train and ride all the way around like we did today. I hope you enjoyed the narration and all the information we had for you. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. Bye!